Hello aqua friends, welcome to my channel. Today we are going to paint realistic watercolor trees. My name is Nicole and let's get started. So the first thing that is part of my painting process with any painting is to plan out your painting, including a good sketch. You could practice techniques on scrap pieces of paper before you get into actually touching the real painting. So I want to show you how I made these sun flares through the trees. My very first layer is just laying down a very light wash and establishing these areas where the sun is coming through the trees. By wetting the area and leaving the center of your light source free from paint, gives the illusion of a bright light. Now, I was really excited to have the illusion of a watercolor back run in that top right-hand corner because there is a sun flare there in the reference photo, as you can see, and I really wanted to play up those colors, those warm yellow oranges and the green from the trees. So I will be coming back to that area to increase the saturation. This is only my first layer. And keep in mind that your first layer is always going to be the sort of ugly stage of the painting process in watercolor. So as we get closer to the light source, I use less paint because the colors are going to be softer close to the light source. And while your paint is still wet, you could also lift areas over the layers that you've already painted to have that light ray effect. I'm building up the colors that I'm seeing in those sun flares, trying to keep things soft in that bottom right-hand corner. And I started off with my oval half-inch brush and between that and my script liner brush, I started painting in the foliage. Which with those two areas of sun, the foliage in that right-hand corner is quite dark and most of it is in the shadow. And instead of doing one layer at a time, I'm sort of dividing my paper in quarters and continuing the layering process of these trees and building up the colors that way. I did this so that I can see if the ideas that I had and the way I wanted to go about doing this painting, if that was going to work. It was kind of hard to tell on a small swatch, and sometimes you just have to experiment and go with your gut instincts. And yes, I know, planning was one of my tips, but planning will only get you so far in watercolor, as you know, as it is an unpredictable media. When it's wet, it does its own thing. So most of the time when I do trees, I use a small round brush, a 6 or a 4 even. And when I did that in this painting, I realized that I loved the effect I was getting, and it was more of that tight, compact pattern of foliage that I usually get. I did my winter trees in the same way, and I will have a link for that video at the end of this video. This is a very fine tip brush. It is from the Princeton Velvet Touch series, and I just think it makes a fantastic texture for these distant trees. I do have a link for a package of Princeton brushes in the description below if you wanted to check that out. So for the rest of the painting, I am building up colors from light to dark, and I am getting this concentrated areas of foliage and this unique sort of pattern with this size 6 brush. Keeping in mind that the point of this brush is so very fine that it probably could be a size 2 at the very, very point of the brush. They're very nice to work with because of that fact that they have such a fine tip to them. So I'm building up the colors around that sun ray, keeping in mind that the colors are going to be very muted. And so the foliage, I am going on the very light hand, very light in color there. Notice that you also want to change your colors often to have a more realistic effect, because as you get farther away from these sunspots, the colors will change. It'll get darker. You'll have pops of more saturation of color in some areas and not so much in others. So as my little section dries, I go back over trying to finish that one branch, getting in those darker hues that I need to. Notice I'm still using a very watery mixture, and I go back over it with more concentrated paint, and I just let watercolor do its magic, because as soon as you drop in the pigment onto that wet surface, it will disperse in magical, wonderful ways like watercolor does. And it's really hard to tell that it's having these different gradations because my brush strokes are so small, but it does make a difference by wetting the paper first versus just using straight paint right away. You do have softer effects with these hard and soft edges. I really recommend using hard and soft edges for a more realistic effect. So to reiterate, my first tip to making the realistic trees is by layers of color, working with these wet and dry edges and building up your colors, slowly dropping in your pops of color into the already wet areas. The second tip is using a smaller brush, because you will get the concentrated areas of foliage, that sort of pattern of distant trees, by using a smaller brush. It makes you slow down. Yes, it is going to take a while to paint in this manner, but I do like the realistic effect that I got. So if you're more of a realistic painter and you like to paint tightly, that will definitely slow you down, is by using a smaller brush. It forces you to add in all these details, and it forces you to paint slowly in building up your layers. So as you see, I'm getting farther away from that sun, and the colors are becoming brighter the farther away I get. I'm getting back more of my concentrated greens. There's going to be some areas of shadow that I have to start putting in there. So there is a lot of work to be done. As you can tell from the reference photo, there's a lot of trees here. This painting made me very happy. I felt very at peace painting this nature scene, and it was just turning out so pretty. I was very excited to bring this to you today to share it with you. Bringing in pops of color, the nice bright greens that I've used were the sap green and Hooker's green. My third tip is vary your colors as you build up your layers. Pay attention to where the light is hitting the tops of your trees. They should definitely be a lighter color. And as you get into the shadows of the forest or the trees on the bottom of your paper, you'll have to vary your colors and get darker. So I'm basically taking clumps of these trees and painting them from light to dark and staying within that one source of clumps of trees, kind of breaking down that reference photo in these different sections. Trying to paint every individual tree will just make you crazy, because there's so much detail in there. You have to sort of give the idea of many, many trees, without going too crazy and doing your best at getting those main shapes in there will give the illusion of a nice, thick, full forest. Now that I have the tree trunks in, I'm working on the next couple of trees. Notice I'm always starting from light to dark. So the lightest colors that I have used were yellow ochre, raw umber, leaf green, sap green, and just a very, very watery mixture. As you can tell from my palette on the right-hand side, my paint consistency is very, very weak there. And that's how I'm building up these lighter areas, just very slowly with very weak paint. Now, as I'm coming in and I have to increase the saturation, notice that I'm increasing the amount of paint I'm using. And so it's just this balance between the amount of paint that you're using and building up colors slowly. All in all, I probably spent about 4 or 5 hours painting. I'm going back over those clumps of areas where I need to increase the shadows. Towards the end of the painting, you're basically looking to see your tonal values and where you might have to make things a little darker or a little lighter. So I'm just trying to get those sun areas as bright and looking as good as possible, adding a little bit more saturation with a few more coats of paint, some glazes of some warm colors. Loving that Hooker's green for a really nice pop of bright green color there. If you want to check out my winter trees tutorial where I paint the trees in a similar manner, click here.